全世界拍电影对我来讲，它使用的语言其实都是一样，工作人员的所有的工作的习惯、习性其实都是大同小异。
It's so interesting when you come to see crews from different parts of the world. It's like you can always see. Okay, he's a sound guy. He's a gaffer, and it's so funny. You can see these are costume ladies. It's all the same type of people.
A big difference is in Sweden we don't have so long working days as here in Taiwan. In Taiwanese crew work a lot and they work very hard.
From Sweden to Taiwan, the first place they thought it was亚热带的气候，穿着凉鞋，穿个短裤就来机场。
We were hoping it should be very warm, but now it's very cold. It's like in Sweden right now, so we are freezing a bit. But I think we can manage.
像这种语言的、啊，就是一定都会有一些误解吧。
I think the hardest thing is the communication with the languages.
你可以理解他们在讲一件什么事情，那个内容你应该大概都可以了解。可是就是他们期待对那个东西期待的程度到哪里，那个就比较难判断。
我觉得最难的就是我站在那边要同时讲三个语言，我常常。跟瑞典演员导戏的时候，突然间用中文跟他导戏，或者是跟副导用瑞典话跟他讲话，反正一大堆语言，我脑袋都快破掉了。后来开始拍了以后，过了几天之后，哎，突然间好像有又出来第四个语言，就是一个那种，我看很感动，就是摄影师跟灯光师他们要讲光的时候，虽然他们有翻译，但是他们的动作常常就是，哦哦，懂。就上光这样子，这个我觉得很妙。
Of course, the language is the hardest thing. After a while, the gaffer knows how I'm thinking, and we talk less and less and less, and just point a little bit, and you go, oh yeah, okay.
我觉得最困难的地方是突破相信这件事情。因为他们是从那么远的地方来，他们也没有在，甚至于没有在台湾，更不可能说搭景或什么，他们完全对我们是不了解的。所以我要怎么样让他们相信搭景是可以的，尤其是一个豪宅。
Hi. Hi. I'm Gwen.
Hello.
Do you work together with him at the office?
张家是在中间后段的地方。
Just want to say hi.
Okay.
我们从一开始一直一关的过到快要到张家的时候，那个相信已经够了，所以我们可以在最好的状态下把它。最大的挑战就是相信。
Can teach me something in the Chinese. 木宝，
木头，
木头。Grand bar.
Grand bar.
Très stone.
Très, très
stone. Grand bar.
Grand bar. Grand bar.